Well, the clock is ticking on Maine high schools to comply with the state's new concussion law, which went into effect January 1st. The Maine Concussion Management Initiative is working with schools to standardize their policies. They have until July of 2014, that is, to comply, and there's a lot riding on it.
Today, 84 high schools meet the state's new benchmarks on concussion management. In the next year, the Maine Concussion Management Initiative hopes to have over three-quarters of the schools up to these standards. The broad focus being
to improve the education and improve the outcomes for those students who do suffer concussions.
Recent studies have found a link between the number of impacts having a cumulative effect that leads to increased concussions.
One of the things that we've talked about at the Maine Principals Association is possibly limiting the number of contact days, not allowing these football players to have full contact practice during the week. On the assumption that if we can limit the number of hits, we can decrease the cumulative effects that are occurring from concussion.
The members of the MCMI admit the challenge of implementing the policies at rural schools who do not have athletic trainers or may share a school nurse. But considering the latest findings about concussions, these are challenges that must be met.
We need to be doing things differently to reduce the risk for concussions. What we've found is as we've sort of opened up this Pandora's box of concussion evaluation, we found that the number of concussions are increasing. And they're increasing, one, because we have better ways to identify it, we have better awareness, but I also think we're seeing more concussions occur.
Simple, bigger, faster, stronger athletes today, and that's what you end up with.
Yeah, really serious, too.
Absolutely, for a lot of people.
A lot of people. All right, thank you, Travis. And Roger's back with Final Check for Forecast. We come back.